Dani. say boy. Boy, you got a lot of nerve sitting in the front row not fucking singing. You do realize what you've done here tonight, don't you? Singing. Because
Yeah. Your blood was soon dark and rich like wild berries.
The blood of the guitar was Chuck Berry red. The guitar bled for about a week afterwards, but it wrung out beautifully.
And I was able to play notes I never even heard before.
So I took my guitar and I smashed it against the wall. I smashed it against the wall. I smashed it against the bottom of Varsity Cheerleader. Smashed it against the hood of the car. Smashed it against the 1981 Harley Davidson. The Harley howled in pain. The guitar howled in heat. And I ran up the stairs to my parents' bedroom. Mumsy and Dadsy were humping away in the moonlight. So I opened the door, creeping in the shadows right up to the foot of their bed. I raised the guitar high above my head, and just as I was about to bring the guitar crashing down upon the center of the bed, my father ran over screaming, "Stop! Wait a minute! Stop it, boy! What do you think you're doing? That's no way to treat an expensive musical instrument!"
And I said,
"God damn it, Daddy!
No, I love it!"
Thank you. So
soul. With as much love as I can possibly give you, and with as much gratitude as I can convey, I say to all of you, for the last 16 years, but especially for the last 10 months, I say to all of you, thank you. Thank you very much.
Sing along.
Miami. That was fucking brilliant. I must say this at this time. Parents, if you were here in this building with someone 12 years or younger, this message is to them. Kids, 12 years and younger, do not use the language that I use on stage. I am a professional. Do not use this at home. Parents, if you are here with someone 13 or older, they're fucking already saying it. And just so I can show you that I know what I'm talking about, she is working her way through college. So I decided I would give her a summer job singing backgrounds in a rock and roll band. Ladies and gentlemen, she is my daughter, Miss Pearl O'Day! He is working his way through law school. So I decided to give him a job. He is my brother, Mr. Tony Loaf! Once again on piano, Mr. Mark Alexander! On the drums, Big Bad John Michelle! It was on a summer night, very much like this one. I was at home. I had nothing to do. Then the phone rang. It was Renee. She said to me, "Meet, would you take me up to the lake?" Renee did not have to ask me twice. So I went to my closet and I put on my very best sport jacket. I got into my 1963 red Ford convertible with white bucket seats. I went to pick up. I'll get it up eventually. I went to pick up Renee. I opened up the door. She got in my 1963 red Ford convertible with white bucket seats. I got in the driver's side. Renee pulled over really close. It was hard driving to the lake, but I managed. When we got there, I put the top down. We looked up into the sky and the moon was full. There seem to be about a million stars in the sky shining down on us. Okay, I'm gonna change that last one, all right? Okay, here we go. You ready? There seem to be about 275 stars in the sky that look like little bitty fucking Christmas tree lights. At which point, Renee made the suggestion, why don't we get into the back seat? Do you think Renee had to ask me twice? So I got into the back seat with Renee, and I put my arm around Renee. At which point, Renee then put her hand on my leg. Was turned on. Renee was turned on. Meatloaf was turned on. And it was paradise, not the dashboard. Thank you. to the word bitch. And the way you look now is that in that picture, you're not wearing a blonde cheek wig. That's it. That's the picture of a bitch.
Thank you.
here it is. Question number two. I would like to know what it was that you were singing.
That it never felt so good.
I know that the entire band, the entire audience, Cheap Trick, myself, we all congratulate you on the last moment, because that was the first thing that you said right in 15 fucking years.
But I wasn't singing to you.
That was very funny. Okay. Little Miss fucking stand-up fucking comedian. I want you to remember this moment. I want you to remember this place. But most of all, I want you to remember these words. I will never, ever do it with you again. Oh yes, I can see it now. I've called the psychic hotline. I can see it now. The psychics are all about me, and they're saying this to me. Meet. She will come to you. She will come to you begging. Meet. She will come to you on her knees. Find out that never again. Okay? Yeah.